Hello, my name is Thomas, and today we are going to talk about TRU's computing science programs. TRU has a Bachelor of Computing Science degree and a Computing Science Diploma program. The Bachelor of Computing Science degree is 120 credits, and each course is 3 credits, so that's 40 courses total. To complete your bachelor degree in 4 years, that means you'd have to take 10 courses per year. The Computing Science Diploma is 60 credits, so that would be 23-credit courses, and again, if you're doing 10 courses per year, that will take you 2 years to complete. The Bachelor of Computing Science program is a little different from some others because it does not have a major. In the Bachelor of Computing Science program, computing science is basically your major, but you can take minors to support your major as well. Some common examples of minors that you can take are leadership, management, marketing, and math. These minors will help support your major and give you some other options once you graduate. For example, a web designer having a background in marketing might be a good option. Different programs at TRU admit students in different ways. The Bachelor of Computing Science is an open program as well as a diploma, which means completion of grade 12 or equivalent is all you need to get in. Specific courses in the computing science programs will have requirements from English and math in high school. For English, the requirement is a 73% or higher in English 12. If you don't have a 73% or higher, then you can write a test to place into first year, or you can upgrade your English while you're in the computing programs. Other courses at TRU will require grade 12 math. The requirements are a C+ or higher in Foundations of Math 12 or Pre-Calculus 12. Again, if you don't have that grade or you don't have grade 12 math, then you can upgrade while you're in the program. This is what your typical first year would look like in the Computing Science Bachelor program. You'll see that you have a writing course each semester and a programming course each semester, as well as a math course each semester. The math can be done in either order, but this is our suggested plan. You also see electives. Computing Science has some different electives that come from different categories. Non-computing electives are any course other than computing science, and non-science elective courses are anything outside of science. We have it set up for 5 courses per semester to keep you on track to graduate in 4 years, but if you'd like to take less than 5 per semester, I suggest putting off those electives. And here is your typical second year in the Bachelor of Computing Science program. You'll see that you have 3 computing science courses each semester, as well as electives. Most computing science courses are offered in every semester, both fall and winter, but we have it set up this way to make sure that you're on track for future courses. We suggest taking computing 2130 and 2230 as soon as possible, because these are prerequisites for most of the upper level courses. Again, if you plan to take less than 5 courses per semester, delay those electives. Other resources that you can use on our website are these checklists and program plans. You'll see the first and second year courses that we talked about already on the left side of this checklist, and you'll see all the electives in the middle. Then the third column is all of your upper level courses. There are quite a few required computing courses, as well as some computing electives, where you have your choice to choose your upper level courses. You'll see a note at the bottom. You do need a C or higher in all prerequisite computing and math courses, so make sure you do well. Another tool that you can use on our website is called DegreeWorks. You can find a link through MyTRU, and it is an online version of the paper checklist. The software looks at the courses you've completed from your transcript and courses that you've registered and pulls them into this checklist for you. You'll see in this example here, the student has some courses that are completed with the green check marks. You'll also see one course in red that they have yet to complete. And at the bottom, there's one course in blue that is in progress this current semester. Let's talk about your next steps. If you haven't already applied, you will have to apply to TRU. If you are unsure of a program that you'd like to apply to, you can talk with our career services team. And I suggest you also talk to people in the field to get an idea of what is involved in each program. If you need help with the application process itself, domestic students can talk to our Future Students Office, and international students can connect with TRU World for assistance. Once you've applied and been accepted, you can do some research on our website. Use the materials that we've talked about today, as well as the academic calendar, and each program has their own faculty website, so reference those as well. If you need any additional help after you've done your own research, feel free to connect with academic advising. If you don't meet the requirements for your program, or you're planning on doing things in a different order, that's a great time to connect with us and we can help you sequence your courses. If you're unsure who your advisor is, you can use our website or contact the main academic advising office. The main things that advising can help you with is making sure that you're taking the right courses in the right order to meet your goals. We can also connect you with other areas on campus that fit your needs. Once all of your planning is ready to go, your last step is to execute your plan. A couple good places to look on the website are the Enrollment Services website for information on registration and wait lists, tuition deposits. And another good place is the New Student Checklist. This goes through in detail all the things you need to do to start at TRU. Thanks for taking the time to see this video, and we look forward to seeing you on campus.